manufacturing technology, we have started the chapter metal joining processes, right? So in the metal joining processes, welding is one of the process which we can use for joining of two metal plates, right? So what do we mean by welding? We have discussed the definition of welding. So welding is a metal joining process in which heat is generated, and this heat can be utilized for joining of two plates together, right? So in the welding processes, in today's session, we are going to discuss on gas welding process, right? So let us start our discussion on gas welding processes, right? So in the welding, our purpose is to generate the heat, and this heat can be utilized in joining of two metal plates, right? So this is the welding process, right? So heat generation is very important. We can generate the heat with help of different concepts, right? So with help of different mechanism and different concepts, we can generate the heat. Okay, so in the gas welding process, as per the name, burning of gas is used. It means burning heat of the gas combustion will be utilized in joining of two plates, right? So here I mentioned the basic fact regarding the gas welding process. So in the gas welding process, heat will be generated by burning of gas. It means by burning or say by combustion of gases, you can generate the heat, right? And this heat can be utilized for joining of two plates and make a permanent joint, right? So purpose of gas welding is, with help of some combustible gases, we can generate the heat and join two plates together, right? So generally oxygen and acetylene gases are used, right? So very familiar and very comfortable process in the gas welding is with oxygen and acetylene. So this process is known as oxyacetylene gas welding, right? So here I mentioned the basic fact regarding or say for gas welding, right? So oxyacetylene gas welding is very important and very familiar process, right? So other process here I mentioned is the oxyhydrogen welding process, right? So welding is very old process, and concept of welding is to generate the heat and to join two plates together, right? So here I mentioned the history of oxyacetylene or say gas welding, right? So historical point of view, here I mentioned the fact regarding the gas welding, right? So this gas welding was first developed and used by French engineers. So here I mentioned the names of engineers also, right? So in the gas welding, two gases are generally used. Here, oxygen and acetylene are used in oxyacetylene gas welding, right? So in the gas welding, or say in the oxyacetylene gas welding, two gases are used, right? So first one is oxygen and another is acetylene, right? So heat is generated by burning of both the gases, right? So here I mentioned the principle for oxyacetylene gas welding, right? So in the principle of oxyacetylene gas welding, there will be one torch, and this torch is used for mixing of both the gases, right? So with help of gas torch or say gas nozzle, both gases can be mixed with certain proportion or say with certain volume rate, right? So by burning of both the gases, flame will be generated, and this flame can be utilized for welding or say for joining, right? So here both plates to be joined are kept on the horizontal plane or say on the work table, and with help of nozzle or say gas torch, we can do the welding. So by moving our torch or nozzle, we can make a permanent joint, right? So both the plates or say metal will be fused or melt at the joint, right? Or say at the middle point, our metal will be melted and make a permanent joint by fusion, right? So this is the concept for oxyacetylene gas welding, right? So in the gas welding, flame will be generated by burning of both the gases, right? So here generally three types of flame can be found while gas welding, right? So here I mentioned the names of flames generated in the gas welding, right? So generally there are three types of flames: neutral, oxidizing and carbonizing, or say reducing flame, right? So here I mentioned all the three names. So let us start our discussion on different types of flame. So first one here I mentioned is a neutral flame. So here I mentioned the view for the neutral flame also, right? So what do we mean neutral flame? In the neutral flame, oxygen and acetylene, both gases are in equal proportion. It means when the flow rate of both the gases will be same, neutral flame will be generated. So here I mentioned the flame view, and here I also mentioned the average temperature generated in this flame, right? So average temperature generated in this flame is around 3500 degrees Celsius, that is 3500 degree Celsius, right? So generally this flame is generated when both the gases are in equal proportion, right? So after that, here I mentioned the carbonizing or say reducing flame. So when acetylene gas flow rate is higher than oxygen, this type of flame will be generated, right? So generally this flame is not used in welding of most of the metals, right? So generally neutral or say oxidizing flames are preferable, right? But remember, when acetylene is in excess as compared to oxygen, reducing or carbonizing flame will be generated. And third type is the oxidizing flame. So when oxygen flow rate, or say when volume flow rate of oxygen is higher than the acetylene, this type of flame will be generated, right? So when oxygen is in excess as compared to the acetylene, this type of flame is generated, right? So here heat generated is higher because of combustion of oxygen, because oxygen is in excess content, right? So these are the three types of flames generated in welding, right? So here I mentioned one video for the welding or say gas welding. So let's have a look on the gas welding, right? So here with help of nozzle or say with help of torch, we can generate the heat, right? So here I mentioned the flame, and with help of this flame we can maintain the heat, or say we can generate the heat by changing the flow rate. And with help of different types of flames, we can produce the heat and do the welding, and we can join two plates together, right? So here I mentioned the welding view in this video, right? So we can join two plates with help of this gas torch, or say with help of this gas welding, and we can make a permanent joint as shown here, right? So this is the concept for the gas welding, and here oxygen and acetylene tanks are used, right? So with help of these two gases we can generate the heat, right? So after that, here I mentioned the equipments that will be used in gas welding setup, right? So here I mentioned the important equipments. So first one is the gas pressure regulators. So here gas pressure regulators are used, and purpose of this regulator is to regulate the flow or say volume flow rate of both the gases, right? So to control both the gases flow rate and control the pressure, we can use the pressure regulator, right? So there will be a welding torch or say welding nozzle. So this nozzle is used for mixing of both the gases, right? After that, here I mentioned the hose pipe. So hose pipe is nothing but it is a durable rubber pipe which will be used for conveying the gas, or say for flowing of gases. So gases will be flowing through these hose pipes. So generally hose pipe is made of a durable rubber, right? So after that, here I mentioned filler rods. So filler rod is nothing but it is the external metal rod which can be used during the welding, right? Oxygen and acetylene cylinders are used, right? So these are the equipments used in gas welding, right? So after that, let's have a look on the view of the general setup, right? So for the gas welding, here I mentioned the setup for the gas welding. So here two cylinders are used, and these two cylinders are nothing but oxygen and acetylene, right? So two tanks or two cylinders are there. Hose pipe is mentioned in this view, pressure regulator is there, and welding torch is also shown in this view, right? So this is the general setup for the gas welding, right? So here I mentioned, as per our discussion, what is the purpose of welding torch? So purpose of welding torch is to mix both the gases in certain proportion and make a flame, right? So here I mentioned the view for the welding torch. And this welding torch can be used for mixing of both the gases. Right? So here I mentioned the view as well as important point regarding the welding torch. Right? So after that, here I mentioned the purpose of different equipments like gas pressure regulator and hose pipes. Right? So once again I repeat, to regulate the pressure of gas, or say to regulate the volume flow rate, we can use the pressure regulator. And hose pipes are nothing but, these pipes are made of a rubber and durable rubber, and the purpose of this hose pipes is to flow the gases from the tank to the welding torch, right? So there are many equipments as per our discussion, and purpose of all the equipment is to do the welding effectively, right? So here I mentioned the filler rods. So filler rod is an external metal rod which can be used during the welding, because when we do the welding, there will be a necessity of external some metal, because when we do the welding, there will be a gap between two plates, right? So to fill the two plates gap, we have to use some metal source, right? So filler rod is used as external rod while the welding, right? So here I mentioned the purpose of the filler rod, right? So here I also mentioned the view for the filler rod, and how can, or say at which angle we can use the filler rod while welding, right? So these are the equipments that we can use in gas welding setup, right? So after that, here I mentioned the oxyhydrogen welding, right? So as per our discussion, in the oxyacetylene gas welding, oxygen and acetylene, two gases are used. But if we are discussing on oxyhydrogen welding, oxygen and hydrogen will be used, right? But storage of hydrogen is bit difficult, right? And there will be risk in hydrogen storage, right? But heat generated in the oxyhydrogen welding is also good, right? So good amount of heat will be generated by burning of hydrogen and oxygen, right? So here everything remains same. In place of acetylene, we can use the hydrogen as well, right? So here I also mentioned the chemical reaction, because here heat is generated with help of this reaction, right? So this heat can be utilized in welding, right? So this is all about the oxyacetylene, or say gas welding setup and equipments. Thank you all of you.